I'd seen enough. It was time to bring this nightmare to an end. Couldn't get that tape out of my head. Why had Ufe killed Rodrigo? I wasn't gonna find any answers in the forensics lab. I had to push on.
I don't think we've been properly introduced.
I know who you are.
Then you should have killed me in the office when you had the chance.
There's still time, meu camarada.
Bodies and still nothing to show for it. It felt like I was detaching, that maybe this was revenge for something else, something buried deep in the past. Rodrigo, Giovanna, Passos. Everyone who'd meant anything was gone. Like so many times before, I'd found myself alone, locked on a course of destruction. It was at my worst when I was at my best. About the only friend I had left in that town. It felt like I was going around in circles, getting further away from the truth. I had to find my way out of there. Becker and Bachmeier had taken their pound of flesh and sold it on the black market. Now I was coming for mine.
Esperando a confirmação do outro grupo, mas o gringo já deve estar morto agora.
Senhor, ele não parece estar morto!
Filho da puta, pelo amor de Deus!
Você tá cego, porra!
way! You Americans love to interfere in things you do not understand!
Oh, I understand plenty, asshole!
How stupid can one man be?
This was the passkey to Becker's office. I was close to the end of all this, and I could feel it.
Becker! Something funny about dying?
I felt like the avenging angel. I looked like a fat, bald dude with a bad temper.
You disgusting piece of shit!
I know everything!
Not everything, my friend. Let go of him, Max.
Huh?
There's a good fellow.
Well, well, well. Victor, I was wondering when you'd reappear out of whatever slimy hole you live in.
I'd like to just say, Max, I just want to say thank you for all your hard work, for my family, and for cleaning up that horrible mess with the Crasha Preto for us. You know I'm tough on crime. I give you a bonus, but I think you just frittered it away. Becker, take his gun.
Thomas, you feel the good.
They had barred the door. My only hope was to chase them down. I knew they'd be leaving town, and my guess is they would try to fly out of here. Rich people love to fly away.
God damn it!
Okay, Max. Now you check the main terminal. I'm gonna go and look for the Bronco plane by the hangar, okay?
Let's do it.
You keep an eye out in there. You know Becker's gonna have some guys in there watching out for you.
Yep.
So, of course, I knew they were looking for me. But the airport was about the only place a fat gringo might blend in. Well, there or a sex club.
Hey.
My delusions of disguise lasted around 2 seconds. They were out in force. And they were out for me. But then, I was out for them, too. Every last one of those bastards.
Oh.
felt like my vacation was coming to an end. Only I wasn't heading home with a sunburn, a bag full of duty-free, and a dose of VD. I was making a bet that would put me in handcuffs or a body bag. These were Becker's guys. Him and Victor had a private airport to go with their private army and their private jet. The doors lead in the direction of the main terminal. The customer restroom. I could get through to the departure gates up ahead. There were Ufe all over the airport, and civilians were being moved out. Looking at it one way, shutting down the airport for their escape was a weird sort of compliment, but one I didn't need. gate had opened at the other end of the departure lounge. Maybe they were in the next terminal. I'd keep looking until Victor sent me a postcard from Miami. To the next terminal was down the escalators. Didn't look like there'd be any trams leaving until the power was on. It looked like they'd cut the power off in the office at the end of the platform. That was where I'd get it running. It worked. The trams were running again. Maybe they'd take me to my gate. Maybe they'd bring more guys wanting to whack me. Maybe both. I felt like I might be able to recharge for a second. At least until we pulled into the station and met more murderous assholes.
Son of a bitch!
It didn't work out like that. Of course there'd be a tram full of goons trying to derail me. Everyone wanted a ticket for the Max Payne Express.
Hey,
I felt like I'd missed out on the joke. And it was a real good one. Come on. The tram was slowing down. And I'd only just gotten on board. I had to salvage what I could and see what was waiting for me. This was my stop. It had taken me right into the heart of it. Becker's gimps were everywhere. So he and Bronco must be close. The smart move would have been sticking with DeSilva and going straight to the hangar. But when was I ever about smart moves? I'm a dumb move guy. Hey, Max, we'll drive onto the runway. No thanks. Let me walk in the main entrance. I'll put a big shit-eating grin on my face and let these assholes take turns trying to kill me. That's my style, and it's too late in the day to hope for change. Boy, were they throwing numbers at this problem. But then, I'd chosen to be here. I wanted this. Was it redemption? Not really. It was pathetic desperation, and not much else. The further in I got, the more guys I saw. Becker wasn't running a police force. He was running an army. These guys were better trained and better equipped than anyone I'd seen out here. And I'd seen some mean sons of bitches. The mission was screaming suicide, but I didn't give a damn. At least I'd die being a pain in the ass. There the bastards were, sneaking off in their rich kid's toy.
I ain't got nowhere else to go, Becker!
Mr. Payne, I believe you had something to say to me. Mate ele! Mate ele agora! Não! Não! Não!
this was it. It was almost over. So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death, and I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. One card left to play.
Just get me close.
Guys are running in over on the right. Over on the right. Oh, good.
Come on. Got a flight to catch.
It's not going to take off without it.
Sums it up.
They're blocking the runway. They're looking at citizens' rights and they're trying to get tagged.
I don't get the sense that citizens' rights are high on their agenda right now.
They behave like an army
and they're equipped like one.
Let him enjoy a trial and a spell in prison. Let him suffer. Trust me.
You know I walk.
You'll walk with a lift!
The 55th Battalion of the City Police's Special Forces Unit, who have been implicated in human trafficking, has been disbanded indefinitely. Meanwhile, Victor Bronco, the politician at the center of the scandal, who is accused of laundering money from the scheme to fund his political campaign for mayor, was yesterday found hanged in his police cell. It's not yet clear whether his death was a suicide or simply retribution for his part in a scandal that has so many families missing loved ones that were kidnapped and killed. City officials say a full investigation is underway.